When all you have is a hammer, then everything looks like a nail.
This saying has been around for a really long time, and it means that if you only have one tool in your tool belt, everything looks like that problem that you can solve with that tool. That is what happens with breastfeeding babies and oral ties. Many providers have a limited differential diagnosis when it comes to solving breastfeeding problems, and therefore oral ties are at the top of their list. The problem is often these oral ties cannot be blamed for the breastfeeding problem that you're having. Hi, my name is Dr. Wadley. I'm a pediatrician, lactation consultant. I'm also board certified in breastfeeding medicine. I created this YouTube channel so that you can have success with breastfeeding. If you enjoy this video, please consider subscribing to our channel as well as sharing this video with one of your breastfeeding friends. In order to understand how oral ties can affect breastfeeding babies and which ones are important in this discussion, we need to start with some definition. Oral ties are small pieces of tissue that are anatomically normal most of the time, and they connect certain structures in the mouth to the mouth itself. When they become a problem is when they restrict the movement of that structure. The three oral ties that we are going to discuss is tongue tie, lip tie, and buccal tie. The tongue tie gets the most pressed. A tongue tie is a piece of skin underneath the tongue that holds the tongue to the floor of the mouth. When it becomes a problem is when it is really tight or short, and it's restricting the movement of the tongue. Breastfeeding babies use their tongue in order to transfer breast milk out of the breast. If the tongue is anchored to the floor of the mouth, then they don't have this ability to use their tongue and breastfeed well. This can lead to mom having painful nipples. This can lead to baby not transferring milk well. So there are certain times that tongue ties are an issue in breastfeeding babies and should be divided. The second oral tie is the lip tie. This piece of tissue is anatomically normal, holds the lip in place along the gum line. Every person is born with this piece of skin underneath their lip. The only time that it is an issue for breastfeeding babies is if it prevents them from lifting that lip up, flanging it out while they're attached or latched to the breast. The majority of the time, the lip tie does not cause any significant issue in breastfeeding babies. And therefore, the evidence does not support dividing this lip tie in order for breastfeeding to be more successful. The third thing that we're going to talk about is buccal tie. Some humans are born with this extra piece of skin on the inside of the cheek that connects part of the cheek to the gum. These are called buccal ties. They are not the cause of breastfeeding problems. I am basing my recommendations that I just explained to you on a position statement that was put out by the Academy of Breastfeeding Medicine in 2021. I will put a link to the position statement in the description of this video so that you can read it yourself. In the last part of this video, we are going to talk about four questions that you should ask yourself before you allow anyone to touch the inside of your baby's mouth with either scissors or a laser. The first question you should ask yourself is, how much is this person profiting off of telling me that my baby has an oral tie? So don't get me wrong. I do tongue tie clippings. I charge money. Yes, I should be paid for my time and expertise. I am talking about people who bring you in, say there's a tongue tie, divide it with either a laser or scissors, and send you on your way after they've charged you lots of money. And they do this repeatedly over and over again. The second thing you should ask yourself is, does this person have a deep knowledge of breastfeeding? Or has your baby already been evaluated by someone with a deep knowledge of breastfeeding who is recommending this provider to divide their oral tie? Like we've said, not all problems with breastfeeding are caused by a tongue tie. So a thorough evaluation from a knowledgeable person is ideal before you head to a provider who is going to divide your baby's oral tie. The third thing is, has someone convinced you that your baby's lip tie needs to be divided because it's causing problems? I'm not talking about when they're older, they have a gap in their teeth, the dentist has followed them over time and wants to divide the lip tie for dental reasons. I'm talking about people who have ascribed the lip tie as the cause for the breastfeeding problem. And it's the same situation as tongue tie. That is their whole evaluation. They flip the baby's lip. It's there. They divide it. They charge you money, send you on your way. The fourth thing to remember about and question yourself before proceeding with oral tie clipping is buccal ties are not a thing. They're not a thing for breastfeeding babies. While the cheeks and the muscles in the face, all of that is involved in breastfeeding, buccal ties do not interfere with those things. In the position statement from the Academy of Breastfeeding Medicine, they recommend against dividing any sort of oral tissue that is called a buccal tie. Recently, I saw a breastfeeding mom and her baby for an evaluation. The baby had a lingual frenulum that was very visible on exam. However, the mom was breastfeeding well. She had had a little bit of nipple pain initially when she first started breastfeeding in the hospital, but has had none since then. And at 2 weeks of age, the baby transferred 2 ounces of breast milk in a fairly short amount of time at the breast. At that time of the evaluation was not causing any issues, and therefore I recommended against dividing the tongue tie. I hope you found this video helpful. Dr. Wadley, bye for now.